Yes.
I'm a living example of it. Look at me. Look at my face. Do I look like a joker?
Yeah.
A prankster? No, right? Well, friends, my face has allowed me to get away with many a trick in my life without anyone ever suspecting I was the culprit. It started with Richie Rich comics that I used to read as a boy. They had advertisements of these fantastic tricks from a company in America. Fantastic things like itching powder, sneezing powder, fake shit, disappearing ink. I was fascinated by these things, but I had no way to buy them. Then one day I was making objects from papier-mâché, which is a paper mash. And I rolled a lump of it in my hands, like a log. And when I looked at it, I was struck that it looked exactly like a piece of shit. Eureka! Within minutes, I had made my first piece of fake shit. After it was dry and painted, it looked like a masterpiece. Now to put it to the acid test. I was staying in my aunt's house at the time. Her son had a dog and she disliked dogs, but his father gave him a dog. So in the evening when we were having dinner, the maid went to the bedroom to make the bed. After a while, the maid came to speak to my aunt and she opened her mouth to say something, but no words were coming out except, Amma. With a lot of prompting, she finally blurted out, Amma, slip me a shat on your pillow. What? My aunt said, and she ran to the bedroom, followed by us. When she saw my creation on her white pillow, she screamed louder, how dare that dog shit on my pillow? And poor Snoopy, hearing the commotion, he also came and he sniffed the shit and looked at us in bewildered innocence. I didn't do that, as if to say, I didn't do that. Then two things happened at the same time. My aunt went to kick Snoopy, and my cousin picked up the shit and threw it at my aunt's face. And so my first trick got off to a great start. I went on to make many more shits. And one day, I had kept many pieces to dry on the sofa outside my front door, in the veranda. And a cat was sleeping in the corner of the sofa. And unexpected guests came home and rang the doorbell. My mother opened the door and seeing the look on their faces and the sight on the sofa, she hurried to explain, oh, the cat didn't do that, my son did it. Recently I saw someone wearing a t-shirt with the words, we never grow up, we just learn how to act in public. When I was almost 30 years, I went to Australia for the first time on work and I discovered a joke shop on the streets of Melbourne. I was thrilled to find that it had all the tricks which featured in those comics which I couldn't buy when I was a boy. I almost bought the whole shop. I couldn't wait to come back to India and try out my tricks, so I tried a few in my office in Melbourne. There was an African Muslim guy who used to make fun of the Indians, so one day I decided to get back at him. After 5 PM in the evening, when there were no Aussies in the office, I and my friends and I, we stuck a remote-controlled farting machine under Hassan's chair, so that the next day I could operate it with a remote control from my desk, like this. It's not working, sorry.
Yeah, I can.
So the next day I walked into office at 9:30 in the morning. The Aussies start work early at 8 o'clock. And I find everyone is going into a conference room and they call me also, so I also went in. As we were going in, my friend whispered to me, you know what this meeting is about? I said, no, what? I said, what we did yesterday, it's about that. I said, ah, no way, you're kidding, you're joking. And I didn't believe him. Then our director, Tracy Martin, started speaking and the blood froze in my veins. She said, this meeting is about the prank that someone played on Hassan Osman. Someone placed an electronic device under his chair and he found it in the morning under his chair. It had the words remote control on it, so he thought it was a remote control bomb. And everyone panicked actually and the floor was evacuated, the security squad was called. and the whole building was going to be evacuated when they investigated and they informed us that it was not a bomb but a prank. And she laughed and said, "I don't want to know who did it, but I just want to advise you that considering the recent bombings in Bali, this is not the right time for such tricks." My blood started flowing again when she said that she doesn't want to know who did the trick. And I love the Aussies even more for being such good sports and not even wanting to know who did it.